Hey, good morning, everybody. It's Mike, and thanks for jumping on with me this morning as I'm a few minutes late. I apologize. I misplaced my phone here, but let's get started. As this week, I'm trying to come up with to highlight a different business strategy to allow you to attract more buyers and sellers, hopefully unique strategies that really don't cost you anything. I am not going to focus about 1 second on this paid lead generation crapola where you are giving away, gosh, I hear crazy stories where you're giving away anywhere from 30 to 60 some percent of your money. You did all the work. All somebody did was forward you a lead. That's crazy talk. So let's just talk this week about effective, unique strategies you could implement, don't really cost anything. Yesterday we talked about a CMA a day to your sphere of influence, your past clients, to other agents' past clients. Today I want to go in a different direction. I'm going to say the video word again today. But before you all weird out on me on this and like, oh, I don't know, I don't feel comfortable doing that, just hang with me for a second, okay? Watch this. The number one search engine on the internet right now is what? It's Google, right? I think everybody knows that. And I think most of you know this. What's the number two search engine on the planet? That's right, it's YouTube. That's right. YouTube, I know we think about YouTube a lot of different ways. We think about it as a place where I can host videos. Well, it's that. It's a place where I can, it's a substitute for my cable provider, right? So I can watch TV on YouTube. Yeah, it's that too. It's an entertainment vehicle. But more than anything, what it is it's a search engine. It allows you to browse for what you want on the internet. Now, video is so effective because people, see if you agree with me on this, people want to do business with people they know, they like, and they trust. If I don't know you, like you, and trust you, I don't care how many trophies you've won. I don't care where you rank in your office. I don't care if you're a real estate agent. I don't know you. And I do business with people I know, I like, and I trust. And if you don't agree with that, then I've got some bad news for you. Then Zillow and Open Door and OfferPad and Redfin and all these big internet data companies, that's who you're competing against. Because they're trying to draw people to them that don't know, like, and trust a local real estate agent. Because the people that I know, they're not turning to Zillow, they're turning to me. When they have a question, they might have been browsing on Zillow, but then they'll say something to me like, Mike, Zillow says the Zestimate on my house is $500,000. Can that be right? They're not trusting it. They're turning to, if they know somebody that they like and they trust, they're turning to me as the credible source. Okay, let's get back to YouTube. YouTube is the number two search engine on the planet. Are you producing content, videos, that people will be browsing for? And how do you know what people are searching for? Well, I'm going to give you a little free tip here this morning. There's an app out there. It's called TubeBuddy. I want you to go check it out today. TubeBuddy. Just Google or YouTube TubeBuddy, and it'll take you there. TubeBuddy is a tool that will tell you the most commonly searched terms that people are using when they browse the internet. It'll go one step further. It will tell you the terms that people are using that people aren't producing content for. So right now I'm sitting in Roswell, Georgia. So let's just use that. I'm going to use that as my example this morning. Our TubeBuddy might say, hey Mike, people are searching for homes for sale in Roswell, Georgia, but nobody's producing content that fills that search criteria. Wouldn't that be interesting to know? Then might I produce video content specifically for that topic? if I only knew what that topic was. What are people searching, browsing for? What terms are they using in their search criteria that content isn't exactly matching up for? And then I want to create that content. And what would that cost me? That would cost me nothing. Zero. That would cost me the willingness to do it. To make, now look, don't make a 10-minute video. Make 10 one-minute videos. If you've got 10 minutes of content, keep it tight, keep it short, keep it on a single purpose. If you've got overflow of content, make additional videos to go with that. Okay? Because watching a video is like being on hold on the phone. It feels longer than it really is. Nobody's watching a 10-minute video. You can't produce one that is so good and interesting that people will hang with you for that long. 1 minute, yeah, most people can handle that. So I want to produce content, video content, that goes along with what people, consumers, are actually looking for. So if they're looking for fixer-uppers in Roswell, Georgia, or luxury homes in Roswell, Georgia, or the best schools in Roswell, Georgia, or things to do in Roswell, Georgia, or the best restaurants in Roswell, Georgia, all these different topics may or may not have anything to do with homes, but I want to be the credible expert on the community in which I live. So I want to be producing video content that matches up with those search terms. YouTube is the second largest search engine on the planet, and TubeBuddy will tell me what people are looking for and what people, where there's a lack of good content to match up with those search terms. And it's all free. So why wouldn't we do it? If it's all free and it's effective, why wouldn't we be doing it? Well, Mike, I feel uncomfortable. Videos, you know, I feel a little scared. Well, Snowflake, here's my answer to you. Go back to bed, pull the covers up, go back to sleep, and get out of the way and let the rest of us go take your business. For those who are a little bit more fierce, who want a little bit more out of life, you suck it up, you rub some dirt on it, and you make the damn video anyhow, and nobody cares how uncomfortable you feel. That's the truth. I'm not going to sugarcoat it. We are, in our businesses, going to have, from time to time, and time to time means pretty much every day, going to have to do things that make us feel uncomfortable. Swallow hard, take a deep breath, do it anyhow. And that's called going out there and making it happen for yourself today.